can you explain what your idea was about?
My idea is about preventing the forest fires, and it has two phases, that is post-disaster and pre-disaster. So pre-disaster is preventing the that is first detecting about the whether the forest fire is going to happen or not. If it gets a confirmation message that there is going to be a forest fire happening, then it will prevent that. And post disaster is that it will inform the fire department, the forest department, and other related departments for putting off the fire and taking other measures needed.
A very warm congratulations for the token of appreciation from Intel India.
Thank you.
So how does it feel when you found out you had received appreciation from Intel India?
When I found out that I'm going to receive a token of appreciation from Intel India, I was happy and also proud that I'm going to be received a gift from Intel India, which is a great company and leading in microsystems. So it was both happy and excited.
So that is very nice to hear. When did you first hear about Ideate for India, and how did you get involved in creating your entry?
I first heard about Ideate for India in the month of March this year. It was during my exams, and I wanted to make an entry because in such competitions, small ideas which can be given great outputs. So it will be very useful for the nation or for the nature or for the people. So it will be always very useful, and it will be a successful outcome.
What did you hope to achieve when you decided to submit an idea?
When I decided to submit an idea, I hope to achieve something which will be useful for the nation and the nature, because nowadays nature is in a dangerous situation. So I want to do something for the nature. So I wanted to achieve something in this field which will help the nature in developing itself.
That is good to hear from youngsters like you. So did you have like several ideas, or did you just settle on your final idea straight away?
Actually, the first idea I got was about preventing the lake fires, because lake fires happen often, but they are due to several other reasons. But the Bangalore lake fires are very different because they are caused by the chemicals which are released into them. So I wanted to prevent them, but when I discussed with my chemistry teachers and the robotics teachers, I found out that it will be a little difficult to prevent them by testing small samples or by running small tests. So then I came up to the next idea, and the next idea was successful, that is the forest preventing forest fires.
Okay. What challenges did you have to overcome to get your idea complete?
The first challenge was my exams and the time management. As I heard about the competition and had to submit my idea, it was during the exam time. I had around six to seven exams left. So it was tough for me to manage the time and come out for a good idea. So that was a few challenges which I had to overcome when I have to bring up this idea.
That's quite brave of you. What do you think about your final idea, and what would you have changed if you had more time?
What I think about my final idea is, it is a idea which can change the life of the fauna which live in the forest and the humans, because forest is not one of the most important for human survival, but the most essential. So it will help everyone. So I wanted. So this will be a good idea, and if I had time, I would have went in detail of this and brought out some other information which can develop my idea.
What advice would you give to students entering the competition next time?
My advice for the students who are entering the competition next time is, rather than creating ideas which can make humans' life easier, we can make ideas which will solve the problems made by the humans, and we can bring out ideas which will help the nature and animals and the plants.
So do you have any plans for your future? What do you hope to do next?
First I have to finish my education, then I plan to do something in the science and computers field.
That's nice to hear.
Thank you.